Hello, and welcome to OptiSigns. My name is Garrett, and today I'll be demonstrating our web scripting app. This is an advanced feature that allows you to automate web page navigation and display it directly to your digital screens without any coding needed. It's great if you need to show a website that requires a login or show an online dashboard in full screen mode. Basically, if the web page you're trying to show requires form entries or any type of navigation, then our web scripting app is right for you. So let's dive in. What is web scripting? It's a way for us to record how we interact with a website. We then copy that recorded data and send it to our screens. Our displays are going to show that website exactly how we interacted with it. Our web scripting app is also encrypted, so you can be confident for safe and secure deployment to your screens. We also support two-factor authenticated logins, and I'm going to show you how to utilize that in the second part of this video. And the last thing I want to point out is that this feature is only available to Pro Plus plans and above. So now we need to record our script. There are many options to record your script. For this video, I'm going to be using Burp Suite Navigation Recorder in my Chrome browser. To use Burp Suite, go to the Chrome Web Store. From there, in the search bar, search for Burp Suite Navigation Recorder. Click on the application, select Add to Chrome, and then add extension. That is going to download. You can turn on sync or close. Now navigate to your extensions. I'm going to pin it, but this is optional. Now what we're going to do is right click on our Burp Suite extension and open Manage Extensions. We need to turn on Allow in Incognito. So I'm going to turn that toggle on, and now I can close this tab. Now that our recording tool is ready, we need to record our script. So what I'm going to do is go to my desired web page I want to show on my display. I'm going to be using monday.com as an example. I'm going to sign in here. Now I'm going to go to the exact URL I want to show. I'm not going to just copy the monday.com URL or the login URL for your site. We're going to let our recording handle the navigation. So I'm going to navigate to what I want to show, and it's this timeline view. So I'm going to copy this URL. Now that I have my URL copied, I'm going to click on my Burp Suite extension and select Start Recording. So now that we're in incognito mode, Burp Suite is already recording all the actions we're doing. So I'm going to paste my URL and hit enter or return. And when my next page comes up, I'm going to type in my login slowly, carefully, and correctly the first time. Because if I mess up here, it could cause problems in our recording. And now after I enter my username or email, I'm going to click on password. I'm not going to click enter or tab. Again, could confuse our recording. So now I'm going to type in my password slowly and carefully again with no mistakes. Hitting the backspace could cause problems. And then instead of hitting enter, I'm going to click the login prompt. And now that I'm logged in, you'll notice it already directed me to the page I want to show. But for this example, I want this page to show in full screen mode. So I'm going to just navigate to that, put it in full screen, and now I can end my recording. But before I do that, I just want to let you know, try not to hit the previous page option here, as that could confuse our recording as well. Just remember, you want to make your recording as perfect as possible. Now, all I'm going to do is close this window. That is going to end our recording. You probably noticed I only showed that dashboard for a few seconds at most. What our web scripting app does is it's going to show that final destination. So when I went into full screen mode, it's going to show this final destination indefinitely. but give a live view of it. So when tomorrow changes, it's gonna show tomorrow. So don't feel like you need to record your script for hours on end. You just need to get to your desired page and then close the incognito window. So now we have our recording. Now we need to create content out of it. Burp Suite is going to automatically copy this recorded data onto your clipboard, but if you need to find it later on, you can just click on the extension and select copy to clipboard. Now, we're going to log into OptiSigns. Once logged in, we are going to go to the Files and Assets tab. We are going to select Apps. We're going to search for Web Scripting, and then we're going to click on the Web Scripting app. Go ahead and give your new content a name, and I'm going to paste my recorded script. Now remember, your script is automatically copied to your clipboard, but just in case you've been recording a few times, go ahead and select your Burp Suite extension and select copy to clipboard. That's gonna be your most recent recording. Block third-party cookies. That's up to your discretion if you wanna turn that on or off. Secret 2FA. 2FA means two-factor authentication. My recording did not require a two-factor authentication login. So anywhere that says 2FA, I'm going to skip for this one. Delay execute JavaScript. This is going to tell your screen the amount of time between each action you took. If I have this set to 10 seconds, it's going to take 10 seconds to log in, and then it's going to take 10 seconds to go into that full screen mode I showed. Now, 5 seconds here for the 2FA JavaScript is already filled in. If you're not using 2FA, it's going to just ignore this, and the delay execute JavaScript will take priority. So you could leave that as 5 or delete it. Now I'm going to just select save. And now we've created content. So I'm gonna take this content and push it to my screen to give you a quick demo of what it will look like. So now you'll see my monday.com screen. After about 10 seconds, it's going to automatically log in. And then once we are logged in, it's going to take about 10 seconds for it to go into that full screen mode that I demonstrated while recording. And there you have it. Now, every time this content shows on a screen, it's going to automatically log in and show this timeline dashboard in full screen with live content from the website. Now, I'm going to show you how to utilize our web scripting app if the site you're recording requires two-factor authentication login. There are just a few extra steps we have to take. The first thing we need to do is turn on 2FA for the site we will be accessing. So I'm going to go to monday.com and I'm going to go through my settings. Whatever site you are using will have different navigation. Add two-factor authentication. Continue. Your screen will show a QR code once you turn on 2FA. Now, before scanning this QR code with an authentication app, you need to first copy the secret key, the secret code, or secret seed. Every site calls it something different. My example says copy code. It is important to be able to get this secret key because we need to input it into OptiSigns. Now you're probably saying, hey, my company already has 2FA activated. How do I find this secret code? You'll have to reset your 2FA settings for your account, and you may have to ask your administrator for your company to do that. But once you reset it, this QR code is going to appear again, and you're going to be able to copy that secret code or secret key. So I copied that secret code. I'm just going to paste it into my notes so I have it for good keeping. And now I'm going to enter my QR code from my authentication app. There are lots of options for authentication apps. For this video, I'm going to be using Google Authenticator. So I'm going to open up Google Authenticator. I'm going to hit the plus sign here and click scan QR code. This is going to connect monday.com to my Google Authenticator app. I'm going to scan the QR code. And now you'll see my monday.com is connected to Google Authenticator. I'm going to type in the code or the token that my Authenticator app is providing and select setup. So now I have 2FA turned on monday.com and I have my Authenticator app on my phone. Everything is ready to record the script just like we did before, except for one thing. We need to remember the code we use to enter the site while recording the script. So I'm going to navigate to my desired URL I want to show, copy, click on my Burp Suite extension, select new recording, paste my URL, doing everything slowly, just like I did before. Select login. Now this is going to prompt my 2FA. So I'm going to open it on my app here and I'm going to take a screenshot or write down quickly what your code is and type in your code. Select login. Navigate to your desired page or view you want to show and then simply close your window. I have my recording. Going to go to OptiSigns, Files and Assets, Apps, Web Scripting. Follow the same steps as before, except this time when we go to secret 2FA. Now remember, that's that original code or secret seed we copied when we turned on 2FA for the site we are accessing. Remember, it's that long one. So I'm going to copy it from my notes, enter it or paste it into my secret 2FA. Now the recorded 2FA code is the 6-digit code we entered to access our website when we were recording our script. So now I'm going to go to my phone, see what that code was, enter that same code. Delay execute JavaScript. This can be ignored or deleted out. But since we are using 2FA, this delay execute is going to trump the non-2FA. And I'm going to hit save. And now let's deploy that to our screen for an example. And it's going to show me log in here. And then it's going to bring up my 2FA and it's going to log in past that. And there it is. Now, every time this asset shows on our screens, it's going to be able to log in using that two-factor authentication and show that live web page. So tomorrow, when the dates change on my timeline here, it's going to be updated. And there you have it. That is how you set up and utilize our web scripting app. I hope this video will enhance your OptiSigns experience and help you display your desired web page. There are links in the descriptions for how-to articles related to this topic. And as always, please reach out if you have any questions. We are always happy to help. Thank you for choosing OptiSigns. We'll see you next time.